Bill Cut. Hello, everybody, far and near. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the Facebook Live class on Communicative English. Dear students and viewers, can you hear me? If not, please let me know passing comments from the comments box that you are unable to reach me. Okay. Hope you are connected with my live class. Okay, dear students, how are you? I wish you are all in a sound health and sound mind and staying in a healthy environment. However, I am Jahid Hassan, working at Dhaka Mohila Polytechnic Institute as instructor of English language, you know. From now on, I will keep going to teach you communicative English online. Dear students, maybe we are getting bored staying home, staying at home for a long time because no academic activities, no campus, and no fun with friends. Therefore, life is getting dull. Am I right? Okay. Don't worry, dear. Hopefully and definitely, we will pick some benefits from the pandemic situations. But remember one thing, stay home and stay safe. No other ways to save our family and save ourselves. And don't forget to follow the health rules prescribed by WHO. Okay, dear students, do you know the elaboration of WHO? Yes, it is World Health Organization. All right, let's go for enjoying academic activities. Dear students, have a quick look at the screen. I think you are watching the first slide. All right, here you see, as I said earlier, that today I will talk about communicative English. Okay, this course is divided into two parts, and definitely for this course your performance will be evaluated by 100 marks. Therefore 50 is for theoretical part and another 50 is for practical. Now I am going with the theoretical part. Okay, I see that we are on lesson 1. The objectives of this lesson, I mean completing this lesson, you will be able to develop creative writing ability. And secondly, you will be able to transfer information that you acquire from your academic activities. And you will also be able to transfer your ideas and knowledge. Okay, and lastly, I see that you will be able to develop communicative competence confidently in the workplace situations. Okay, go for the next slide. In today's lesson, we will focus on vocabulary, phrases related to time. Okay, you know that in learning a language, it is urgent to know or to become efficient in four skills, that is reading, writing, speaking, and listening. Okay, and listening skill is prioritized to give the first priority. You know, it is given the listening skill, it is given the first priority. But today I will not talk about listening skill. I will talk about reading skill, writing skill, and speaking skill. Okay, I think that reading skill will be practiced on screen through answering questions, and writing skill will be given to practice as homework, you see. And ultimately, speaking skill is expected or supposed to be practiced online with the topics given for homework among friends, teachers in a group. I will talk about later in the later slides how you can create a group to carry on conversation with your friends, teachers, whatsoever. Then go for the next slide. Okay. I said that we have to go for reading skill practice today. Regarding this, our topic title is text messages to a friend. And during this lockdown situations, you are I hope that you are used to write text messages to your friend, because you have no way to meet with your friends. So it is the only way to communicate with your friends. So rightly, we are going to read a text conversation between two friends to practice and improve your reading skill. Now, we will read a text message between two friends, Arif and Neela, and from where we will try to pick the messages information they give when you will seek for evaluation. Okay, and before going to reading task, we need to do some works that is called pre-reading activities. And firstly, do the preparation task and then read the text to do the exercise. Okay, don't worry. This task is very easy, I think. And it is nothing but to check the level of information we have about the topics. Okay, and then in preparation task, you have to match the times 1 to 6 with the words A to F. In the next slide, you will get this information. Okay, here you see, as I said at the very beginning, that we have to learn some vocabulary related to time. Okay, so here is a table, you see. And in this table, in my left, time is mentioned. And in right, in my right, you see how words are mentioned. So you see number 1, 10:55. Number 2, 11:40. Number 3, 10:45. Number 4, 11:50. Number 5, 11:15. Number 6, 11:30. Okay, these are the numerical numerical words, okay, on time. So we have to convert it into a language. Exactly, always we don't say like this. So it's very easy, I think, that you have to match from table left to right. Okay, so consider the first one, 10:55. How it can be written or how it can be said in a language that is a 10:45. This is not the right expression. So what will be the right expression? You see, okay, it would be 5 to 11. And secondly, 11:40. It is given on B, that is 5 to 11. This is also the not the right expression. So what will be the right expression? 20 to 12. Okay, and then question number number 3, 10:45. It is given 11:15. Okay, I think that this is not the right answer. So the right answer will be 10:45. And number 5, 11, number 4, 1150, given language is 1130, but this is not the right matching. It would be 10 to 12. Okay, 10 to 12. And then number 5, 1115, and the given words are 20 to 12. This is also not the right expression. So right expression will be a quarter past 11. And number 6, 1130, the given words are, the given phrase are 10 to 12. This is also not the right answer. Okay, right answer will be 1130. So students, I hope that you have got the information from here, how to convert the numerical time into language. Okay, go for the next. All right, now we are in the real text here, and we have to read it out. Hope that you will read it out with me aloud, and because if you read aloud, then it will help you to become confident in speaking. So try to read it out with me. All right, here is a conversation between Neela and Arif. Hope that they're planning to go for a meeting or for get together, and perhaps the venue is they selected, that is a restaurant. Okay, so go through the text. Neela: Hi Arif, are you there? Arif: Hi, I am here. Neela: Pretty good. Arif: What's up, Neela? Neela: Would you like to meet for a coffee? Yes. When? Arif: I'm working now, but I finish work at 5, maybe at 5:15. Okay. Then, Neela: That's difficult for me. Can we meet 30 minutes later? Arif: Okay. Where? Neela: The Gloria jeans is nice. I love the tea there. The Gloria jeans is nice. I love the tea there. Arif: It's closed on Monday. Let's go to the Hungry Max. It's new. Neela: Is it good? Arif: It's very good. Neela: Where is it? I don't know it. Arif: It's next to the school. See you there. Neela: Okay, see you there at 5:45. Okay, dear students, have a quick look again and try to read it aloud, and then we'll go for the to solve some problems, you see. Okay, go for the next slide. Hope you have read it. Okay, in task one, here are some questions given, and the information taken. The questions are made on the basis of the information of the text conversation between Arif and Neela, you see. And you have to choose the right answer and encircle the best answer. Okay, the options are given here. So first question: What does Neela want to do? Go to a cafe, go to a cinema, go to a class. Okay. So students, try to guess the right answer from here, you see. And so far I guess that the right answer is that is go to a cafe. Okay, question number two: What does Neela finish? What time does Neela finish work? Okay, the options are A, a quarter to 6, B, a quarter past 5, C, a quarter to 5. Okay, try to find the right answer and try to encircle it. Okay. Then Okay, I think the A is the right answer, quarter to six. Okay, go for the next question. What time does Arif want to meet? Options are 5 o'clock, B 5:15, C 5:45. Okay, I hope that C is the right answer. 5:15. Okay, I hope that you have understood the question and you have successfully answered the question. So go for the next slide. Okay, question number four. Why does Arif like the Gloria Jean's Cafe? Options are there. It's new. It's got nice tea. It's got nice coffee. Okay, perhaps so far I guess that B is the right answer here. It's got nice tea. Okay. Go for the next question. What is the problem with the Gloria Jeans? Is there any problem with Gloria Jeans? Of course. That's the reason why they have to change their venue. Okay, so its options are there. It's closed on Mondays. It has not got any tea. There is no problem. Okay, I think that first one is the right answer. It's closed on Mondays. Okay, go for the next question. Number six, where are they going to meet? The Gloria Jean's Cafe, B, the Hungry Max, C, the school. Okay, dear students, this question is for you. I don't want to tell you the right answer. You will find it out. Okay. Okay. All right. Boys and girls, you have nothing to be worried. These questions are very easy, as it is the first class with you. So I think from the next, we will try to give you most updated text to solve the problem. Anyway, task two. Here are some sentences are given. You see, in a table, and you have to. The sentences are given in my left. And you have to read it out, and after reading you have to find out that which sentence is true or false. If it is true, you just write at the right corner, I mean in the answer part. If it is false, then write it there. Okay. First sentence is, Arif writes to Nila first. Is it true or false? Of course, if you do remember that Arif, it is Nila who write first. So ultimately the answer is false. Nila is at work. Is it true or false? Yes, of course, this is true. And the Gloria Jeans is closed on Mondays. Okay. This is also true. Arif knows Gloria Jeans. Okay, this is also true. And then they are going to meet 6:15. Can you remember? Do you remember the time that they meet 6:15? Yes. I think that this is false. Okay. So for the next, Nila can meet at 5:45. Is it true or false? I hope that this is true. Okay, dear students, we already did the second task today, and we are at the end of the session nearly. So we have to go first and go for the next slide. Okay, group discussion. This is very, very important part for you. And you should be informed that you have to do some homework, and you have to do all this thing in your home, as because our institute is closed, so we have no way to go to the campus and do to get engaged with academic activities. So this is the alternate way to get engaged with the academic activities. So it is urgent and it is must to do homeworks and to do all these things, and ultimately you have to submit the documents you'll prepare. Of course, you have to submit it to your respective teachers of your institute, and consequently, after the evaluation of your activities, you will be evaluated finally, okay, in the final semester. Rightly, I have set some questions here for your group discussion and for homework. For group discussion, as I said, that you can create a group online and you can converse there. Ultimately, and I hope that you will carry on conversation with your friend, and it will help you to become competent and confident in speaking. And I may help you a little that where do you usually meet your friends? Okay, we got some experience from the text conversation between Arif and Neela, and in connection with that very experience, we can go on or we can carry on conversation with our friends over night. Okay. And another thing is very important for you, dear students, please don't answer yes, no. Okay. Don't finish your answer writing simply yes, no. Just you lengthen the sentence. If it is yes, you just write why you answered the answer in this question saying yes. Of course, there are some reason behind. Okay, if you say no, of course there is there are some reason behind. So you write it down, okay, and try to lengthen the sentence. Try to increase the number of sentences. Okay, it will help you to become confident and competent when you go for speaking with your friends. Okay, right, wrong does not matter here. Okay. Then secondly, what time do you usually meet? Okay, you can answer these questions of your own. How long do you stay in meeting there? Okay, what are the topics do you like to discuss there? And how would you describe your friend? This is also very important question. Okay, sometimes we see that when we do some activities on Facebook, post some photos, post some funny videos, post some funny comments, then our friends wait to learn from their friends how he or she looks like, and how he is found there. Whatsoever, it is very important and very interesting among the teenagers. So you can write about your friend like this. And lastly, write about the Facebook live class in short. This is very, 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 very important, as because this is the first time we are going to experience this, the incidents, the activities that is happening right now. So That is, as it is very new experience, and also for you, this is the first experience of doing academic activities online on Facebook. So we want to know from you, how do you feel staying here with your online teachers? So try to write it attentively and try to, I think that it must be positive. Okay, thank you very much. Go for the next slide. You see, as I said, that this is the first class with me, so you have nothing to be worried. Answers key is given here, so you can mess the answer from the answer key so that you can count yourself how many right answer or correct answer you have, you did. So you can count your level. Okay, go for the next class, next slide. Okay, this is also very, very important, because we should like to thank our government and Ministry of Education, Ministry of Technical Education, and at the same time we should give big hands to the A2Y, because they help us to become live. They help us to, they have created these sites, and we got the opportunity to do some academic activities here. So they deserve it. Okay, and if you want to watch this video once more, then of course you have to keep watching and get connected with www.skills.gov.bd. No, you have to discard the last word, that is DT, or not necessary. Simply you just go www.skills.gov.bd or www.facebook.com/skills.gov.bd. Okay, thank you very much to stay with me, and our session is almost over, and this is my particulars, and thank you so much for staying with me for a long time, and I think that you have understood well. If you fail to understand anywhere, any slide or any matter, you can ask me question, you can write me now. What is your problem? Your problem. So my contact address is given here. My phone number is 0172116480. My email number is zhaluk@gmail.com. And ultimately, my Skype ID is jahid.hassan720. Okay, you can call me, you can write me messages, you can mail me, or you can call me over Skype. And lastly, I used to give you tips, that is, you see, URL is written, website address is written, and this website is very important for the students. If you want to global, if you want to join with the global conversation to improve your English speaking and to improve your listening skill, of course you can visit there. The address is gigglefestuniversity.com/learn-english-by-speaking-english-for-free. This is the website operated by native speaker, and it is almost free. You have nothing to pay. We can join there and you can boost your English language speaking. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you all. And don't forget to stay home, stay safe, and don't forget to sanitize your hand. Don't forget to wash your hands with soap once more in a day. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.